Hey folks, Valentin the Mad here, and this is Upcoming Gore, where we analyze and discuss response mechanics seen in videos of unreleased games. We'll do some speculations too, and when the game comes out, we'll see whether or not those were correct. So recently, a viewer of the channel let me know that 83, a game done by Antimatter Games, the folks who made Rising Storm 2 Vietnam, is getting Gore and Destruction. Now, RS2 was a lot of fun, and gore-wise, it had some great features, but also very notable issues. Well, looking at this dev diary, I gotta say, seems like a lot has been improved. So, let's dive into it and dissect what we have. So first up, we have a very violent dissection of the limbs. And as you can see, it looks very much in the style of Red Orchestra 2, and that is absolutely a good thing. Dismemberment looked quite good in that game, and this basically looks like a prettier version of that, which I am happy to see. Next up, you have wounds at the point of impact for both gunfire and knives. Rising Storm 2 also had this feature, but the issue there was the blood on the character. What you had is a generic overlay, and that means you basically had blood soakage variations divided into head, torso and each limb. So every time you hit one of those areas, the blood would always appear in the same spots, and the result was all the bodies looking very generic. Instead of seeing blood around the hit itself, it would always appear in the same places. Seems like that is no longer the case. Looks like the blood appears directly around every single wound. I assume those specifically are just fresh wounds that didn't soak yet. The issue I can't spot here though is bloody wounds appearing on a helmet, which is not quite right. Moving on to blood spilling. So first up, we have response stains if there's a surface directly behind the character, and as you can see, those look quite nice. The issue is though that when there is no surface directly behind the character, I'm not seeing anything. It's a common issue in many games I covered and discussed on the channel, and hopefully that can be fixed. Next up, you have a bleeding feature, also something that RO2 and RS2 had, and once again, the looks are just way better in this one. The next feature is blood pools, and those also look quite nice. Seems like multiple of them spawn for that messier feel. Now you can see a few interesting details in this video. It looks like they'll form below the killing hit. You can see it pretty clearly here. You may also see puddles form below dismembered stumps. You can see it here, but not in this one. Not entirely sure what's going on. It seems like blood pools responding to slopes may be a feature. They had it in RS2 and it looked quite cool. And lastly, seems like you have stains or small puddles below dismembered limbs and chunks, and I like it a lot. Now the thing I do want to finish with about blood spilling is that I hope that blood and bodies can be configured to stay the way they do in Red Orchestra 2, either in the options menu or in an accessible INI file. Of course, that is entirely client-side, so if you have the horsepower and the will, you can get some really amazing looking aftermaths. No pre-made level design can compare with fields getting filled with dead bodies in real time as the match goes on. And that aspect is one of the most memorable ones for me gore-wise in RO2. Like, no other wargame I know of does that, and the few it delivers is really exceptionally amazing. Now as for the animations aspect, we haven't seen much about it. I assume we'll have probably something along the lines of RS2, a 7 seconds long active ragdoll if you hit some specific area, but we'll see what the game will end up having. Now let's touch on Destruction 2. So first of all, it's going to be all pre-made, which makes perfect sense for this type of a game. It's multiplayer, 80 players, big battles, you can't really synchronize detailed physics in something like this. So it's going to be pretty much in the style of Arma 3, but prettier. Objects going into a destroyed state once hit by something heavy, with stuff like windows being breakable in between. What is not entirely clear from what I saw is the scope of it. Just how much from the environment can get destroyed? You can blow up a tower. Well, Can you blow up a hut? And as for craters and vegetation, pretty sure that if terrain deformation and vegetation obliteration were features in the game, you would have probably seen it here. So I assume it's probably not gonna be in. In conclusion, I think it is looking promising. Gore-wise, it looks like a pretty notable step up from RS2, and I'm glad to see that destruction is going to be a factor at least to some degree. And of course, when the full game will come out, I will make videos showcasing and discussing the response mechanics, likely both Gore and Destruction. So I hope you enjoyed this video, do let me know what you think in the comments below, and subscribe for more response-related content coming your way soon. Until next time!